Hello friends, welcome to another episode of Techie Tuesdays. I'm your host S. Ravi Kumar. Techie Tuesdays is a weekly show where I answer your tech and career related queries. So if you like my answers, then please hit that like button, subscribe to my channel and share this video with your friends, family and colleagues. Now let's get started with today's questions. Today's first question is by Amulya. He's asking, is it a good idea to develop your own apps than hunting for developer jobs? Amulya, there is no correct answer to this. The answer will differ from situation to situation. So let's say if you are a fresher or if you are a student from a well-to-do background. By well-to-do background means you are coming from a business family who has a financial backing to back you up, then probably it's better to focus on the business side and develop your own app by hiring developers rather than searching for developer job if you are thinking about going into the job. So if you are planning to be a developer and or if your goal is to create your own app or a product, then rather than searching for the developer and if you have the financial backing, then it is much better to hire the developers, hire the good developers and let them develop and you focus on the business side, because as a businessman you should focus more on developing business side of the thing rather than development or implementation side of the thing. You should of course know about it, so you should of course learn about the development and you should of course know about it, like what all technologies are being used, what are the benefits of using those technologies, how much support is there, what is the cost of the resource and everything, because see, both of these are two different things. So it all depends on what is your goal and what is your background. As I said, if you are from a well-to-do family, it's much better to focus on the ownership side of the thing rather than development side of the thing. So, and this applies to you developing your own apps also. So if you are an expert and also you have the backing that okay, you know that you can develop an app within 6 months or within 4 months and you have financial backing to back you up your day-to-day expenses, then better develop your app on your own as a side project rather than searching for a job. So it's always better, but it depends on what is your background. If you have enough financial backup, then of course it's always better to develop by your own. But if you don't have that kind of financial backup, then it's better to learn, have a financial backup first, then go into developing your own app, because at the end of the day, you have to eat also, you have to live also. So that's the main thing. Next question is from Pawan. He's asking, how much should I charge for part-time web development? Pawan, there are two ways to do it. Number one, if you are a working professional and getting a salary in a company, even though it is not advisable to work as a part-time web developer in freelance if you are already working as a full-time developer somewhere, but still if you are working somewhere and you are drawing some salary, so one option is to ask for first calculate your hourly rate as per your salary. So let's say your salary is 50,000 per month, so calculate it, that how much you will get per day and then how much it comes to per hour. So calculate it that and then ask for 1.5 times of that. So let's say if your hourly rate comes to 250 rupees or 500 rupees per hour, then you should ask for 1500 rupees per hour. So ask for regular from your regular salary. So whatever salary you are currently getting, ask for 1.5 times of that or like equal to that. So calculate hourly salary. So it depends upon your expertise level and your confidence level that how well you can sell your services. Either ask for 100% of your whatever hourly you are getting in your job in that, or ask for 1.5 times of that or 1.25 times of that. But don't go beyond 1.5 times because you won't get, there will already be a lot of competition and people in the market. So it's better, because Indian people most of the time bargain, so it's better to ask for 1.5 times of that and then probably bargain it to 1.25 times or similar to your hourly salary of your day job. So that is one way of calculating it. The second way would be to go on the freelancing sites as a probably as a product owner or as a owner of a you can say of a company. So create an owner account and look for freelancers on that company and search for your technology and your experience level. If you are a fresher, search for that also, like experience level from 0 to 5 years or 0 to 2 years. You will still get freelancers who are of experience level of 0 to 2 years in the list and in your technology. So first take out the list of that and based on that list, calculate it that whether it is sustainable for you or not that much salary, and if it is sustainable then take the amount from there. Whatever the best matching profile of yours is taking, ask for that amount. I think these two are the best suitable way for asking, like taking for finding out how much you should charge for your part-time job. Next question is from Aradhana. She is asking, how can one become a successful software developer without any degree in India? Aradhana, in simple words, no, you can't become a successful software developer without any degree in India. Because degree is the stepping stone, or degree is the first step to get a job in India. For any job, be it software developer or be it any job, you require a degree to get the job. Even for applying the job, you will require the degree. Some companies have their HR policies written that they require a person with a degree to get a particular job. So unfortunately, you can't become. There are exceptions. Of course, there are exceptions everywhere. And to become an exception, you have to work very hard. And so why work hard in a particular thing? Better work hard in your college degree. Earn good marks so that good companies should hire you. Otherwise, if you don't want to do it, then you have to become specialized in something, and in that scenario, you don't require a job. Probably you might start your own business. So if you want to be a successful web developer, so when I talk about successful software developer or successful web developer, I'm talking about a success in job rather than success in business. So because a successful software developer is not a businessman. Successful software developer is basically a successful software developer. He is a consultant. He is a software developer. And for software developer, even to work as a freelancer, he needs some kind of degree, some kind of expertise. He has to showcase his experience. And especially if you are a fresher, then I'm sorry, your degree and certifications are required. At least in India, you said without a degree in India, without a degree, unfortunately, you can't become. And those who are telling you that you can become a successful person without a degree in India, they are just fooling you. Frankly speaking, they are just fooling you. They are just there to mint your money. Unfortunately, this is the harsh truth of life, that you require some kind of degree or certification related to the expertise on which you are working on to become a successful software developer. Next question is from Nido King. He's asking, I feel like I won't reach anywhere in my web development. When I look at hardcore developers, I feel like there is no way I can become something like them ever. If I practice for ages, what should I do? Nido, it's a classic case of imposter syndrome. And you are not alone in this. Everybody, even me, also sometimes feel like this, what you are saying. Whenever I go through Twitter and see so many content creators, so many developers developing different kind of applications, even I feel like same sometimes, that I am nowhere in comparison to them. The best way to come out of this is count your blessings. In other words, keep a note of small successes which you have done, a small application which you have built, a small complex problem which you have solved. Note down all those things, and whenever you feel like these, try to see on those, and probably some appreciation from people, read those appreciations or affirmations. Many people say affirmations whenever they feel low or whenever they feel demotivated. So there are many ways to motivate yourself. It's like, yes, many people feel demotivated and many people feel imposter syndrome. As I said, that it is a common scenario in every industry, not only in IT industry. And I am telling the solution which I apply on myself and which works on myself. But frankly speaking, I am not a, you can say, psychiatrist or someone who can like a qualified professional to guide you come out of this. But as a person who has faced this imposter syndrome many times at many places, at that time the best solution I see is to count my blessings or to count my accomplishments, and probably you can say your friend to praise you or to tell good things about you. So I think those are the only things which can uplift you from this kind of thinking. But don't worry, this happens with everybody and it is just a mental block. There is no problem with you. You are already a good developer, that I am assuming. But this is from your question, I am thinking that, or from your question, I have analyzed that this is a clear case of imposter syndrome. Don't worry about it. Probably look for solutions for this. The solution which which worked for me, I have already told you that I count my blessings. So I would say that you should also start counting your blessings, say praises for yourself, or you can say do self affirmations every morning or whenever you feel like this. Next question is for Constantine. He's asking, as a front-end developer aspiring to become full stack, which back-end technology should I focus on? Node.js, Django, .NET or Spring? Constantine, there are only two things which you, two frameworks which comes into my mind in which you should focus on, or I would suggest to focus on, in my opinion, it would be either .NET or Node.js or Deno. Deno is also growing, and it depends on your front-end expertise or front-end strength. So in front-end development, if you are good in HTML and CSS, then in my opinion you should go for .NET, because using .NET you can if you learn .NET, C#, you will not only become a full stack web developer, you can also learn mobile application development and all other plethora of things which .NET framework is capable of. But if you talk about only just Node.js or Django or Deno, all these frameworks are primarily for web development only. I haven't heard of any other implementation of these framework anywhere else. So I would say that rather than learning Node.js, Django, you should go with .NET, learning C# and .NET. Of course, my suggestion would be biased because I am a big supporter of .NET technologies, but that is my opinion. So since you ask for the answer to me, my opinion will be always biased toward C# and .NET. But if you are very good in JavaScript, then you should go with Node.js and Django. But again, Node.js and Deno. But again, as I said, that I'm not very much well versed with any other implementation of Node.js and Deno apart from doing web development. And since your criteria or your requirement is to become a full stack web developer, so in that scenario, if you are good in JavaScript, you can go with Node.js and Deno. If you are okay in JavaScript and fine with HTML and CSS, then you should go with C# and .NET. Next question is from Lekhit. He's asking, how do I find best freelancers? Lekhit, there are two ways, or I would say three ways, of finding freelancers or any kind of employee. The number one is referrals. So you can ask your friend or you can ask your colleagues in the industry to give you referrals of good freelancers. So that is the first way to find the freelancer. Then probably you can talk with them about their charges and whether they are suitable for your company culture or not. That is the one way. The second way of finding freelancer is, of course, via job portals. However, there are very less job portals which give you options to find good freelancers. And the third way, or I would say the most popular and you can say most utilized way, is to find freelancers via freelancing sites like Upwork, Guru, or Top Talent. Or the site is toptal.com. So that is Top Talent. So these two, three sites are the best place to find freelancers. And whenever you have to find a freelancer on these sites, they have given, I don't know about Toptal, but Guru, Freelancer, and Upwork, all these three platforms give you freelancer ratings also. So the thing is that you have to post a job post there that you are looking for someone to do this kind of job, and you are looking for monthly engagement or you are looking for hourly engagement. So those kind of things, and they take a cut, of course, but you will get good resources there, because there you can get resources. They have the rating systems, they have the feedbacks from their previous clients, and they also have customer feedback option also. I'm not sure about that, I haven't given any, but yes, they have feedback from both the sites. So based on that, you can decide that who is the good freelancer for your job in your budget. So I think the third option would be best suitable, or the first option, that is finding referral. The job portal one is so and so. So these were my answers to your tech and career related queries in this episode of Techie Tuesdays. If you like your questions to be featured in next episode of Techie Tuesdays, you can DM me your questions on any social media platform. All my social media handles are Techie Rathore. I hope you like my answers, and if you like my answers, then please hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, and share this video with your friends, family, and colleagues. So until my next video, take care. Bye-bye.